हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम बैक टू माय चैनल एंड नॉट मी ऑन योर फिंगर टिप्स। सो एज वी हैव स्टडीड अबाउट क्लेविकल एंड स्कैपुला, नॉट स्टैंड फॉर ह्यूमरस। सो विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम लेट्स गेट स्टार्टेड विद द ह्यूमरस इन डिटेल। ओके, सो ह्यूमरस इट्स द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन ऑफ अपर लिम। रिमाइंड माई वर्ड्स, इट्स द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन बट ऑफ ओनली अपर लिम, नॉट ऑफ द होल बॉडी। द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन ऑफ द होल बॉडी इज फ्यूमर, नॉट ह्यूमरस। इट्स द लॉन्गेस्ट बोन बट ओनली ऑफ अपर लिम एंड इट्स अ बोन ऑफ आर्म। दोज बॉयज हु गो टू जिम और गर्ल्स, दे नो दैट द आर्म विच द मसल प्रेजेंट इन आर्म इज बाइसेप्स। सो द बोन प्रेजेंट इन द आर्म रीजन इज नोन एज द ह्यूमरस। इट्स द ओनली बोन प्रेजेंट इन द आर्म रीजन। ओके, इट बेसिकली कनेक्ट्स द स्कैपुला विद रेडियस एंड अल्ला। स्कैपुला वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड, इट्स अ शोल्डर बोन एंड रेडियस एंड अल्ला इज द फोर आर्म बोन विच विल गो ना स्टडी इन द लेटर सेक्शंस। इट हैज थ्री पार्ट्स, अपर एंड, लोअर एंड एंड शाफ्ट। द शाफ्ट इज बेसिकली कनेक्ट द अपर एंड द लोअर एंड। ह्यूमरस अपर एंड कंसिस्ट ऑफ राउंडेड हेड, नैरो नेक एंड टू प्रोसेसेस विच इज़ ऑल्सो नोन एज द ट्यूबरकल, ग्रेटर ट्यूबरकल एंड द लेसर ट्यूबरकल। इट्स लोअर एंड कंसिस्ट ऑफ टू एपिकोंडाइल्स, टू सुप्राकोंडाइल्स, टू प्रोसेसेस ट्रॉकली एंड कैपिटुलम एंड थ्री फोसा, रेडियल, कोरोनाइट एंड ओलेकरन फोसा। सो लेट्स सी इन द डायग्राम वेयर आर दीज लेबलिंग्स लोकेटेड, एक्चुअली लोकेटेड। सो दिस इज द एंटीरियर व्यू ऑफ द ह्यूमरस एंड बिसाइड दैट इज द पोस्टीरियर व्यू ऑफ द ह्यूमरस। सो द अपर हेमिस्फेरिकल और राउंडेड इज इट्स हेड। ओके, जस्ट बिलो द हेड इज नोन एज द एनाटोमिकल नेक विच बेसिकली डिवाइड्स द हेड विद द शाफ्ट। ओके, जस्ट बिसाइड द एनाटोमिकल नेक ऑन द लेटरल साइड वी हैव ग्रेटर ट्यूबरकल एंड ऑन द लेसर साइड, ऑन द मिडल साइड वी हैव लेसर ट्यूबरकल। दीज आर बेसिकली पार्ट वेयर मसल्स और टेंडन्स ऑफ मसल्स अटैच। ओके, वी विल स्टडी लेटर दैट हुज विच मसल्स बेसिकली अटैच टू दीज ट्यूबरकल्स। ओके, एज आई हैव ऑलरेडी सेड, ह्यूमरस हैज टू नेक, एनाटोमिकल नेक एंड द सर्जिकल नेक। टू रिमाइंड दैट और टू ग्रैप दैट यू कैन ऑल्सो लर्न लाइक दिस दैट ए कम्स बिफोर, सो इन दिस ऑल्सो एनाटोमिकल नेक कम बिफोर बिफोर टू द सर्जिकल नेक। ओके, सर्जिकल नेक इज जस्ट बिहाइंड द एनाटोमिकल नेक। द रीजन विच बेसिकली प्रेजेंट बिटवीन द ग्रेटर एंड लेसर ट्यूबरकल इज नोन एज द इंटर ट्यूबरकल ग्रू और बाइसिपिटल सल्कस। ओके, वी हैव वन ट्यूबरोसिटी ऑल्सो विच इज प्रेजेंट ऑन द लेटरल साइड इज नोन एज द डेल्टॉइड ट्यूबरोसिटी। एज द नेम सजेस्ट, डेल्टॉइड मसल विल going to attach here. Okay, now comes to the lower end of the humerus. It has two epicondyles, lateral epicondyle which is on the lateral side and the medial epicondyle which is on the medial side. Just above the epicondyles it has two supracondyles which is known as the lateral supracondyle and the medial supracondyle. Okay, just below the epicondyles we have two fossa and two processes, capitulum and trochlea are the two processes where actually the ulna and the radial bone we are going to attach, and the radial fossa and the coronoid fossa just above the capitulum and trochlea processes. Okay, now come to the posterior view of the humerus. On the posterior view, as if we see the humerus on the posterior side, on the back of the side we saw a groove, a deep line or a deep portion which is known as the radial groove. Why it's called as the radial groove? Because the radial nerve will going to pass through it. Okay, with the posterior circumflex artery which we will gonna study later in the upper limb sections. On the lower end of the posterior view we have one fossa which is known as the olecranon fossa. Here the olecranon process of ulna is going to attach, will going to attach. Okay, and olecranon process is basically palpable, you can easily see at the elbow joint, easily feel or see at the elbow joint. Okay, now let's first study about the upper end. अपर एंड हैज़ थ्री थिंग्स, राउंडेड हेड, नैरो नेक एंड दी टू प्रोसेसेस. सो फर्स्ट लेट टॉक अबाउट द हेड. हेड ऑफ द ह्यूमरस इज हेमिस्फेरिकल, विच आई हैव ऑलरेडी स्टेट, विच फेसेस मीडियली लेटरली बैकवर्ड एंड आर्टिकुलेट्स विद द ग्लेनोइड फोसा ऑफ द शोल्डर जॉइंट. सो वट इट वॉन्ट टू से इज दैट अप द हेड ऑफ ह्यूमरस इज मीडियली एंड स्लाइटली अपवर्ड लोकेटेड, ओके, एंड स्लाइटली अपर इन पोजिशन एज यू हैव सीन इन द डायग्राम ऑल्सो. एंड इट आर्टिकुलेट्स, आर्टिकुलेट्स मीन जॉइंट, जॉइंट विद द ग्लेनोइड फोसा ऑफ शोल्डर जॉइंट, ग्लेनोइड फोसा ऑफ स्कैपुला ऑल्सो. ओके, आई हैव ऑलरेडी टोल्ड यू दैट स्कैपुला इज द शोल्डर बोन, एंड ऑन द लेटरल साइड ऑफ स्कैपुला वी हैव ग्लेनोइड फोसा वेयर द हेड ऑफ द ह्यूमरस विल गोइंग टू अटैच. ओके, इट हैज नेक, इट हैज टू नेक, एनाटॉमिकल नेक एंड द सर्जिकल नेक. एनाटॉमिकल नेक इज बेसिकली विच सराउंड्स द हेड, ओके, जस्ट बिलो द हेड और द जस्ट आउटर लाइनिंग ऑफ द हेड इज नोन एज द एनाटॉमिकल नेक. एंड इट सराउंड ग्लेनोइड और आर्टिकुलर सर्फेस वेयर द ग्लेनोइड और ग्लेनोइड कैविटी और ह्यूमरस विल अटैच. द फर्स्ट लाइन, सर्कुलर लाइन इज नोन एज द एनाटॉमिकल नेक. सर्जिकल नेक बेसिकली कनेक्ट्स हेड टू द शाफ्ट, ओके, एंड इट्स प्रेजेंट जस्ट बिलो द ग्रेटर एंड लेसर ट्यूबरकल. ओके, नाउ कम टू द ग्रेटर ट्यूबरकल. एज इट इज ऑल्सो द पार्ट ऑफ अपर एंड, इट इज लार्ज, ग्रेटर एज द नेम सजेस्ट, पोस्टीरियरली प्लेस प्रोजेक्शन डैट प्लेस लेटरली, इट इज ऑन द लेटरल साइड. इट्स अ पॉइंट, ये इट्स अ पॉइंट वेयर many muscles will going to attach. On it has three facet also, superior facet, inferior facet and the lower facet. On the superior facet, supraspinatus muscle will going to attach. On the inferior facet, infraspinatus muscle will going to attach, and on the lower facet, teres minor muscle will going to attach. Okay, you can learn like this, that superior, so supra, inferior means infra, okay, and on the lower facet you have to mug up this teres minor muscle going to attach. Okay, crest of greater tubercle form lateral lip. Crest of there is some like a projection like area on the greater tubercle which form the lateral lip of bicipital groove. I have already told you that bicipital groove is the space between greater and the lesser tubercle. Okay, and on the lateral lip of bicipital groove, on the lateral side or lateral lip of bicipital groove, pectoralis major muscle will going to attach. Okay, now come to the lesser tubercle. Lesser tubercle is smaller, as the name suggests, placed anterior medially. ओके, anterior medially means it is present on the medial side, and don't confuse here also written that anterior laterally, but to the head of humerus. If we compare the position of lesser tubercle with the head of humerus, it is anterior laterally. Okay, here on the lesser tubercle, subscapularis muscle attached to it. Okay, it also has crest like the greater tubercle. The crest of lesser tubercle form the medial lip of bicipital groove because it the lesser tubercle present on the medial side. Two muscles will going to attach on the medial lip of bicipital groove, which is teres major and latissimus dorsi. The don't confuse here that this is teres major, and we have studied about teres minor in the lower facet of greater tubercle. So teres minor will attach to the greater tubercle and teres major will attach to the medial lip of bicipital groove. Okay, and you can also learn like this that greater, okay, greater join with the smaller minor, okay, and the lesser tubercle mean lesser join to the major like this. Okay, bicipital groove, it's a space or deep groove between the two tubercles. I've already told you. Now come to the shaft. Okay, we have completed the upper end. The shaft of the humerus is triangular and cylindrical. If we cut section, if we see it in our hand, if we take humerus in our hand, it is slightly triangular or cylindrical. It has three surfaces: anteromedial, anterolateral, and posterior. Anteromedial means if we see on the anterior side, the medial surface is known as the anterior medial surface. Okay, if we see on the anterior side, but to the lateral surface, lateral border. Okay, so we call it as anterolateral. Now third one is posterior. Posterior is just area between the medial and the lateral borders, okay, and just from the posterior side. Now come to the lower end. Lower end, I have already told you, it has two processes, and two epicondyle, two supracondyle, and the three fossas. Okay, so let's talk about first fossa. It has one bigger fossa, which is known as the olecranon fossa. It articulates or accommodates the, accommodate means it grabs the olecranon process of ulna during extension of elbow. If we flex, what do you mean by flexing and extension? Let's study about this first. Flexing means if you fold your hand or leg, this is known as the flexion. Extension means if you extend your elbow or extend your hand, okay, that's the extension position. So when you extend the ulna, the olecranon process of ulna joined to the olecranon fossa, okay, and if you bend your hand, if you flex your hand, the olecranon process slightly remove from the olecranon fossa, okay. Now second one is coronoid fossa. It's larger than the olecranon fossa and receive coronoid process of ulna. Olecranon fossa accommodates with the olecranon process, which is present on the posterior side of the ulna. Okay, we will study it later. Okay, and you will get to know much better about this in later section when we will study about ulna. Okay, so coronoid fossa basically receive the coronoid process of ulna, as the name also suggests. Now come to the third fossa, which is radial fossa. It receives the end of radius through some ligaments, which we will study later. Now we have two processes, capitulum and trochlea. Capitulum is a rounded projection which articulate with the head of radius. Trochlea is also a part of, trochlear notch is also a part of ulna. So trochlea attached to the trochlear notch of ulna. It has two epicondyle, lateral and medial epicondyle. It basically non-articular, that means nothing going to attach with it. Okay, it has two supracondyles, so lateral supracondyle and medial supracondyle. Okay, so let's study about the muscle which going to attach in the on the humerus. Okay, so see in this diagram, I have mentioned about all the labelings of the humerus, so without wasting times on labeling, we will only study about the muscle which will going to attach on the humerus. Okay, supraspinatus, as the name suggests, it superior facet of greater tubercle. Supraspinatus muscle will going to attach on the superior facet of greater tubercle. Here is the subscapularis attached to the lesser tubercle. Okay, now these three muscles, pectoralis major, latissimus dorsi, and teres major, these muscles show here the bicipital groove on the lateral lip. Lateral means on the lateral side, lateral lip of bicipital groove, pectoralis major will going to attach. On the medial lip, teres major will going to attach, and on the middle, latissimus dorsi will going to attach. Okay, I already told you that on the lateral side it has one tuberosity known as the deltoid tuberosity, where the deltoid muscle we're going to attach. Okay, now as we will go further with the muscle of upper limb, we will going to study more and more muscles of arm. Okay, so there are three I will tell you in the short that humerus has arm has three muscles. Okay, coracobic, brachialis and the biceps brachii. Okay, so this muscle here is the brachialis muscle, which is a muscle of arm. It starts from the mid of the humerus. Okay, and it will going to attach to the other parts of the forearm or other bones of the forearm. Here is the coracobrachialis, which start from the coracoid process of scapula, and it ends in between the humerus. So you can learn like this also, that coracobrachialis start from the scapula and end at middle, and at the middle the brachialis muscle will start and end at the other portion. Okay, on the radius or ulna, or maybe on the forearm bone, you can say easily. Okay, because you don't study about the ulna radius here. Okay, so you don't know where is the brachialis muscle actually attach. We will study it later. Okay, so this is the posterior view. Here on the upper side, upper end is the on the upper end it is the infraspinatus muscle which attach on the inferior facet of greater tubercle. We have teres minor muscle. I have already said you minor will going to attach with the greater. So teres minor muscle will going to attach on the lower facet of greater tubercle. Okay, here the triceps muscle also, you have to remember this, that we have actually four muscle of arm. On this, three muscle on the anterior side of arm and one muscle on the posterior side. So tricep, if someone out of you going to gym, some boy or girl, they know about the triceps or biceps. Okay, triceps is basically the posterior muscle of the arm. Okay, so it present on the posterior side. Okay, so here is the deltoid tuberosity, which is on the anterior side also. So deltoid muscle attach, and tricep, as the name suggests, it has three heads. Okay, so the medial head of triceps is there, which constitute the longest or the highest part of the humerus. Okay, so this is basically about the humerus. So thank you guys. And I will upload the notes in the description box, and you can I have attached my mail also in the description box. You can check it out, and please don't forget to like, subscribe and share my channel. Okay, if you have any doubt, you can comment me down. Okay, thank you.